The sun, here I am. Hello everybody, welcome. Giada Valenti here in Las Vegas. I hope you guys are doing well. I was laughing at the comments of Phil Carafice, who said, "That doesn't look like Giada." Yeah, I'm the other Giada, not the Giada De Laurentiis, the chef. I'm Giada Valenti, the singer who loves to cook. So, welcome, welcome, welcome. That's the answer to your question, whether I don't look like Giada De Laurentiis. I'm a singer and songwriter from Venice, Italy, if you are new watching for the first time. But let me first welcome everybody of my circle of love, the people that that have been with me since the beginning of this Giada life. How are you guys doing? And welcome to all the new people like you, Phil, that I see you for the first time. So all of you watching for the first time, I guess you're watching through the page of Italian Living, my friend Richard Micheli, that, by the way, had his birthday this week. So happy birthday again, Rich, if you're watching, and many, many more birthday for you to come. Circle of Love, how are you doing? It's 2 p.m. here in Las Vegas. Of course, it's 5 p.m. for you watching on the East Coast. Always many people watching from the East Coast. We learned during the Giada Live the time zone of everybody. So we know that it's almost time to go to sleep in Italy for la mia mamma and mio papà, because it's 11 at night over there. we always have people from England where they are 1 hour behind, so we know that there is 10 p.m., so a little bit earlier. And of course, good morning, buongiorno a tutti quelli che ci guardano dall'Australia. Good morning to the people watching from Australia. Always many of them. A good afternoon for Halton. So I guess, where are you, Halton? Where is your place? So if you are new, by the way, let us know at the Circle of Love where you are watching from. We always like to know what time it is and where you're watching from if you're watching for the first time. Welcome, welcome, welcome in American Sign Language. We always do also American Sign Language here on the Giada Live. If you're wondering, when did we start with the Giada Live? A little bit of history. We started almost a year ago, March 18. My last concert was in Las Vegas, March the 12th. I was missing my audience. I went in front of a camera for a quick hello, and Giada Live was born. We did 100 days nonstop where I was singing, cooking, and interviewing some of my amazing, amazing friends. And now we go on two, three times a week. Some days, of course, on Thursday is always the Italian episode, like today. On Saturday, I'm always cooking some delicious recipe, and of course on Sunday on my Patreon page I'm always singing a song because you guys love my singing as well. Today, you see on the back, I took you to my hometown. Today we will be going to Venice, where right now it's the Carnevale, it's happening, yes, right now. And you can watch it, by the way, virtually. I will make sure to send to put again on my social pages the links, and you can watch a lot of the events that normally you have to be in Venice. Now you can watch them virtually. We are going to Venice today. Actually, I will be cooking for you something that is a traditional sweet that we make in Venice during the Carnevale, which is called Crostoli. And I'm going to tell you a little bit more of the history of this delicious sweet. And at the end of this Giada Live, I will also be singing a song for you, a romantic song. Since Sunday, it's going to be Valentine's Day. So if you're watching for the first time, I see many of you and you want to stay updated, please like my Facebook page and subscribe to the YouTube channel. Many of you are appearing also from YouTube. Hello, YouTuber. So, and if you're watching for the first time and at the end of this episode, you're like, hey, I like these things, you may have missed more than 250 episodes, but you still can watch them all on giada.life. And when you have nothing to do, you go there and you hear me sing, talk. I will actually interview also some amazing friends. And so you're going to enjoy everything. So what did I do this week? Well, it was a busy, busy week for me. Probably the busiest of the year. I sing about love. Valentine's Day is coming up Sunday. So all this week I was recording at least two or three or four songs a day on Cameo. Is this page where people can request, all my friends and family and fans and angels around the world were requesting me special song with special messages for the people they love, being their a lover or also a friend. So I've been celebrating Valentine's Day, I think somebody called it. So Valentine's Day is for lover and Valentine's Day for friends, wishing love and the best to each other for Sunday. You still can do it if you go on Cameo. I still have a lot to do, but if you send your request today, probably I still can do it because it still is Sunday. So I want to start right away before we go to Venice for this recipe. I want to start congratulating my dear friend Rita Monte, radio DJ Rita Monte. That today she's celebrating right now on the radio 25 years of Profumi d'Italia, an amazing Italian show, radio show that she does from Long Island. Been guest of Rita many, many times. So congratulations, Rita. I made yesterday a nice greetings for her where I said to her she's grande, 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 like the song that I always sing, 25 years. Can you imagine, guy? And this is not a paid job. It's just something that she does to promote Italian cultures and music. Before I see a lot of you appearing, hello guys, I see a lot of you new, please let me know where you are watching from. And many of you said, when are we going to Italy? Yes, sick and tired to be home, me too, I cannot wait to go to Italy. Virtually, going virtually to Italy is being fun, but are you tired to stay home? You want to come with me? Next year with Perillo too, we have to skip this year because we still don't know if by October we're going to be out of COVID. So with Perillo Tours, we decided to have the trip to Italy next year. So 1 year from now, and of course we will go to Venice, Rome, Florence, cooking classes, singing, wine tasting. You can go on my page, giadavalenti.com, and you can find there all the information about the trip, and you can push like I would like to stay informed, and we will keep you informed about when we will start. You can start booking your trip. Last episode, 2 weeks ago, actually last week I was busy singing. I didn't go live on Thursday. I took you to Venice for Il Carnevale, and I told you all about the maschere. If you want to know everything, all the mask in Venice, the one that you see, that the two masks there are wearing something called Il Volto. And if you are curious to know, I share with you all the history of the mask, all the mask, the shape of the mask as history and names. Volto, Moretta, you see, the most popular actually is Il Volto. JJ keeps showing this picture. But remember, we talk about, that's Il Volto, this is a more famous one, but I told you also about the Moretta, the one that you need to put in your mouth, is the one that I own myself, made by my friend Sergio Bondrin. Was very popular among the women, because to keep the mask in place, the women needed to bite the mask, so they were not allowed to talk. So men really loved women to wear the mask. Not so much so now, but at the time, apparently, when Carnevale started. So if you want to catch that episode and learn everything about the mask, you can go on giada.live and you can find that episode and find everything about the mask. Today we go again to Venice, but this time I take you to Venice with a recipe. So without further ado, let's go to Italy. And so buckle up if you're for the first time, you don't know, we're going to travel virtually. We travel to Italy, to the booth of Italy. So buckle up and let's fly to Italy. Here we go. A worldliness from Venice to sky high Manhattan. I'm in love with life. I love the cosmic lobster on my worldliness. From Sydney to the streets of London, everywhere I go, I have in my core the place where I'm from. Welcome to Venice. Yes, the place where I'm from. That's my song, The Place Where I'm From. I wrote a song about my city. I see many comments of you have been to Venice and you guys loved it over there. You were Sandra, she said, I was there in 2002 and 2018. Love it. Awesome. So you were able to go to Venice just like I was in 2018, and then everything stopped. So if you want to come back with me, you know, of course, and I see also Susanna, she said she was there in 2007. If you guys want to come back with me, go on my page and we can go together next year with Perillo Tour. So before I take you to my kitchen, because as I said, today we go to Venice with a recipe, I want to share with you a little bit of history about this, the things I'm making today, the crostoli, this traditional sweets that we make in Venice for Carnevale. And I saw already somebody, I think it's Roberto Calloni, said, are they not called Galani? Good question, Roberto, because actually they are called many, many different names. It's a very old dessert, the crostoli, that's how we call them in Venice. It's been fried far and wide throughout the peninsula of Italy since the Roman times, so very long, long time ago. And it looks like crostoli is one of the oldest term for this sweet, and since it was used also by the ancient Romans. But there are so many different regional different names, so here I find them all. So crostoli or grostoli in Veneto, Trentino, Friuli, but also Galani indeed, like you said, Roberto, when they're a little bit thinner, but they call them also bugie in Piemonte, in Liguria, cenci or crogetti in Valdarno, chiacchiere in Umbria, in the parts of Lazio, Abruzzo, Molise, a little more on the south. As you can see, they call them cioffe in Abruzzo and Molise, cresciole in Pesore, oh, cunchielli in Molise, fiocchetti in Emilia-Romagna, frappe in Umbria and some place of the Emilia-Romagna as well, frappole, sfrappe in Toscana, galarane o saltassù in Bergamo and Sondrio, I know I've heard the name, galle in Vercelli, in which is Piemonte, grasse in Monferrato, guanti in Trigoni, lattughe, meraviglias in Sardegna, different name because it's an island completely detached from Italy. I never heard the name, so I have to ask my friends from Sardinia, guys, if they are exactly the same recipe. Marviglia and Val d'Aosta, they speak French over there, but they call also spelle, stracci, so many names. You can go back later on the program and see that card. I mean, it's unbelievable. It's the same name, a different name actually for the same recipe. The principle behind the recipe is almost the same. It's a mixture of flour, sugar, eggs. Some recipe also includes some alcohol like brandy, grappa, vin santo, marsala, depending on which region they are making. And they're all fried in oil and dusted with sugar. A little bit of history, though. As I said, this dessert take traces back to the Romans' time, so many, many gazillions of years back, before the world was born, I would say. And they talk about, actually, the Crostularius, which was a pastry chef. I don't know if I'm... Yeah, Antonio, there you are. The pastry chef, Antonio Argentieri, it's our chef, pastry chef, yeah, in the Circle of Love. There was apparently, Antonio, this chef called Crostularius. He was a pastry chef who prepared the crustulum. There was a dessert that was a sort of crunchy crust that was fried and passed in awning. They are not passed in awning anymore since the Middle Age. After the Middle Age, no longer was sweetened with awning, but with sugar. The crustulum is actually also, I've learned, an evolution of a salty kind of a lasagna. It was a kind of a paste they were making. They call it a passepartout. That was going well with all kind of food in the Roman cuisine. And it was a descendant of the lasanon. That was a Greek kind of crust bread that they were making, the old Greeks. It was prepared by mixing spelt or wheat flour with water and was crushed with rolling pin and cut into stripes. And baked or fried, and seasoned with salt, and consumed with chickpeas. They talk about it in the old Romans documents. You know me, I did the classic Lyceum, and I have read all about these kind of things, which is funny that now, when I'm preparing for the show, all this old knowledge comes back to my mind. So my parents would be very proud of me. So we are in Veneto. I was born and raised in Venice, Italy. If you're watching, I'm a singer born and raised in Venice, Italy, with this passion for cooking and for food. So today I use the name Crostoli. That's how I was born to call them when I was a little girl. And yes, somebody said they also call it Galani in Venice, and it's true, more in the region of Verona and Padua, and they are a little bit thinner and a little bit more elongated in shape. And about the origins of so many names, actually Galani, Roberto, you may not know, or maybe you knew, comes from the Spanish name. You know, the Venetians had a lot of trades with the Spanish people, so comes from the word gala, which means bow tie. And actually, the Galani have a little bit more kind of a shape of a bow tie. So, you know, the bow tie that you put around the neck. In Tuscany, they also call it straccio, which means rag, because it looks, they are very thin in Tuscany, so it looks like a piece of fabric. But they also they call it frappa, or fringe, from French, in the parts of Piemonte, where they are more close to... the French border. They call it also chiacchiera napoletana, and actually I've learned which is the chatter, and actually properly they say come from the chatter of the nuns. Apparently they were famous for chit-chatting and making them apparently in the loro conventi. They also call them lies, which means bugie, the bugia, which means lies, and is a little bit a figurative meaning of deception. Who knows what the story is of that? So many names for the same delicious food. So today I'm gonna make the traditional crostoli, the one that I learned to make thanks to my grandmother first, and now my mamma, la mia mamma che ci guarderà domani perché adesso sta dormendo. Let me read some of the comments. Buonasera, buonasera. I see Guadalupe. Hey, Guadalupe, my Bulgari girl. You know, when the concert were going on, I was always wearing these beautiful Bulgari jewels, and Guadalupe, she works at Bulgari, the best jewels in the world, and I was the lucky one wearing them. And she said she loves my hair. Thank you, Guadalupe. I am going crazy and wild because spring is coming. Yes, the winter is about to finish. COVID is about to finish. So let's go free and be happy. So many names for the same delicious food, the crostoli. And now I want to take you to the kitchen and I want to show you how I make the one that my mom told me how to make. So here we go. Let's go to my kitchen right now. Ciao, benvenuti benvenuti nella mia cucina. Hello, welcome to my kitchen. Today, actually, I'm cooking something delicious for Carnevale. Yes, it's Carnevale. So today, I want to share with you a family tradition, the authentic recipe for the Venetian Crostoli. My mom makes the best, and this is a recipe. They are light, crispy, and very addictive, so be careful if you are on a diet. We call them in Venice crostoli, but they're also called chiacchiere napoletane in the south of Italy, Neapolitan cheddar. Different name for the same food. It's something very common in Italy, especially when it comes to food that have religious roots. For example, this, the chiacchiere or crostoli recipe. Perhaps you already know that Lent is a solemn period in the Christian religion, a period of roughly 6 weeks, I would say, before Easter Sunday. Not a coincidence that this fritter, so this crostoli of chiacchiere napoletane, would be made on the eve of Ash Wednesday, the day before Lent began. The day before Lent, yes, is the last day of indulgence, indulgenza, before the 40 days of fast. Since all indulgent foods are forbidden during the Lent period, non si possono mangiare, it would make sense to have one rich meal on the eve, and this would definitely include the desserts. In Italy, and also here in the north of America, Mardi Gras, il martedì grasso, is the last day of the Carnival festivity. Lots of celebrations, which usually means for us Italian people, lots of food, and crostoli are among them. So here are the ingredients. I'm making the crostoli only for me and JJ, so my recipe is a small batch for two people. E adesso facciamo i crostoli. Let's make the crostoli. Noi si vedrà quello che verrà. E avremo un cielo immenso e chiare. E stelle da guardare e sogni che ci faranno vivere. Sarai profumo, sarai la mia pelle, un vestito che non cambierò. Nel tuo cuore io vivrò. Avrai amore da negarci dentro, avrai tutto quel che vuoi, avrai l'eterno per scandire il tempo. And here it's our dough, it's ready. We put it in a bowl and we cover it up with some plastic foil, and we put it in the refrigerator for 30 minutes, and then we're gonna make I nostri crostoli. Here we go, 30 minutes in the refrigerator. Hey Google, set timer to 30 minutes.
30 minutes, and we're starting now.
So here's our dough. It was in the refrigerator for 30 minutes. And now we are ready to make the crostoli. Adesso facciamo I crostoli. Make sure that you have some flour here, because you're gonna use it here and there, also on the plate where you're gonna put the crostoli. You made some flowers everywhere, and we're gonna make it. So you can make it, if you don't have this pasta machine, everybody has one in Italy. Should you not have this one, you can buy it on Amazon, or you can use the old-fashioned pastone. I'm gonna use the machine. Wouldn't you send me your way? Ask me to stay. Could I take the truth?
I just want to love you.
here is our last one. So now we have our crostoli and we need to fry them, so I'm going to the stove.
Parliamo d'amore, di quello che resterà. Se un giorno finisse tutto qua. Parlami di te, dei sogni tuoi, amore se vuoi. Comincia pure, vai. L'amore.
And here are my crostoli. Yes, I am ready now for Carnevale. I even have my moretta over there. Remember, we talked about the mask? So I'm gonna have a little bite of one of my crostoli to see if I've done a good job. They're nice and crunchy and sweet. So guys, I hope you're gonna try to make them. If, remember, if I can make it, you surely can do better than me. So I would say buon Carnevale and buon appetito! And here they are. Yes, I've been a good girl. I made them and I did not eat them because I am on kind of a diet together with my friend Natalie. She's in France. I'm here in Las Vegas and we are doing a diet together where we are not allowed to eat the sugar. So I'm going to put them in a box and they're going to be good like for a week or something. So here and there I can bite one me, one JJ. So. And maybe I'm gonna see, I think some of my friends, I'm gonna give them to them. So guys, if you make this crostoli, they are delicious, of Galani or whatever names you have. I see that many of you that were calling them bow tie. Yes, it's true. This is one of the name. Please, if you make them, Jenny of Diane, Elena, all of you are watching, if you make them, please send me picture. Talking of which, Elena, I mentioned Elena. Elena, our member of the Circle of Love, has become a nonna today. She got a baby. Baby Francis is born. The little baby was born this morning. Francis Jr. I cannot wait to meet him. I'm going to be Aunt Giada, Zia Giada. So congratulations to Frank and Elena and Rocco. And poor Rocco, the Doberman, of course, if you've been following me, you know how much we love Rocco during the Christmas, when we filmed the Christmas concert. Rocco was always there. Today he went to the hospital, he had a little surgery. Thank you, Rogers, for letting me know, and I hope he's doing well. So congratulations. I see Lisa is giving congratulations to Elena. And Frank, you are here in Vegas with Rocco. I will text everybody later to know how he's doing, Rocco. I was with Rocco, so let's pray for Rocco. Talking of the circle of love, Tuesday, I was blessed and lucky to see Roger, our member of the Circle of Love, and because he gave me, you remember, he got me a piano, two guitars, and the guitars did not have a stand, so he bought me a stand for my two guitars that he gave me, and he gave me this card. It's a beautiful card, and it, of course, with Venice. Can you guys see? I was like, where did you find it? And I read you what is written. So it's a Valentine's card, but it's beautiful because it said, so glad you are mine and to the circle of love. So thank you, Roger. And the names here are Roger, Diane, Denise, Jenny, Janet, Sal, Elena, Frank, Rocco, Antonio, Richie's there, Doug and Susie, and everybody else from the Circle of Love, Alejandra, and much, much more success. Look at this beautiful card. So thank you, Roger, that you found this beautiful Valentine's card with my Venice and the gondola. And remember, if you want to come to Venice with me, I know you all of the Circle of Love are going to be with me, but should you be new today, and we see also a lot of people appearing for Periscope, you want to come to Venice with me next year, please go on my page and you can find all the information. I do the trip every year together with Perillo Tour, and we go to several cities of Italy. You can see all the itinerary if you go on the page. And of course, there is always cooking classes, not by me, by real chef. They're always wine tasting and a lot of fun. And there is always at least one little private performance, little concert done by me. And we think next year we're gonna do it in Florence. So please check it out, the trip information, if you wanna come to Italy with me. Continue to like all my pages on Facebook and subscribe to my YouTube pages. Keep doing so. You guys are doing amazing. I see the number going up. So, and I thank you from the bottom of my heart. You know, I need you to make all these things happen. And keep continue to listen to my music. You guys always send me this amazing, beautiful message that my music is with you in the kitchen and in every moment of joy on Spotify, Apple Music, and Amazon Music, as you see there. Please like my page for a simple reason, because I post on my Facebook page the one that need the likes. So no, the one where we are friends, but the one that needs the like. Make sure that you follow me there, because I post there all my events. And this week is going to be crazy. Tomorrow morning, I am going to be guest again of a podcast. I did one yesterday. If you go on my page from Little Italy in Los Angeles, with Deborah Zara. So if you go on my page, you can see the one of yesterday. It was very nice to talk to Deborah. If you're watching, it was a pleasure to talk to you. And tomorrow morning, I'm going to do another one in Chicago. I put the details on my page, but it's early in the morning, it's at 10 p.m. And then later in the afternoon or morning, I don't know the time yet, I have sang a song for my dear friends Lina Prima, yes, the daughter of the one and only Mr. Louis Prima. She has now a radio show called Buongiorno Louisiana, and she has a special episode for Valentine's Day tomorrow, and I will be singing a song for her to wish everybody Valentine's, Happy Valentine's Day. That is going to be Sunday. So please like my Facebook page to be sure that you can see all this event. And of course, I'm going to be singing a song for you. And if you like what you hear today, I will invite you all to join me this Sunday. Every Sunday, we do something called the Love Song Sunday. And me and my team awesome, as I call them, we gather together at 2 p.m. Vegas time. And every Sunday, I sing beautiful songs to them. We did a tribute to Dolly Parton when it was her birthday 2 weeks ago. We did Neil Diamond tribute. We had something with all kind of music. Every I always try to keep an eye who is having a birthday, which kind of celebrity singers is having the birthday, and I sing at least one or two songs. So this Sunday is going to be special. It's going to be all kind of love songs. I have already some requests. So guys, if of the team awesome that you're already there, if you have a song you want me to sing, make sure that you write a message on my Patreon page. We test this microphone, test. So Sunday is going to be my Patreon. It's a subscribe page, so you pay $1 and you subscribe. And then if you like it, you go to the $10 level and you can be with us every Sunday. Because it's a much smaller group, we can always chit-chat with each other. Actually, that's where the circle of love is really intimate and beautiful. And we always have a lot of chat and support with each other. And most of all, we share kindness and love beside the music. So here we go. I decided today, because Valentine's Day is coming up, to sing one of my favorite songs. Something that, you know, I've sang so many times, of the Carpenters. And we all would love to be close to one to another. So here it's Close to You. And you guys, if you are there, take a glass of wine. And if you have a Crostolo, buy the Crostolo and I sing a song for you. Happy Valentine's Day, guy. Here we go.
Why do birds suddenly appear every time you are near? Just like me, they long to be close to you. Why do stars fall down from the sky every time you walk by? Just like me, they long to be close to you. On the day that you are born, the angels got together and decided to create a dream come true. So that sprinkle moon dust in your hair of gold and starlight in your eyes of blue. This is why all the girls in town follow you all around. Just like me, they long to be close to you. Why? Close to you.
Close to you, yes, close to you. That's where I would love to be right now. I know we are close one to another, just on the social media, but of course, be on a stage in front of an audience will be different, and hopefully this will happen soon. So I am gonna see you Sunday on my Patreon for the Valentine's Day episode. Please join me there if you are not. Thank you for the applause. If you want to send a request for a cameo video to wish happy Valentine's Day, of just to say to somebody that you like and let them know that you love them as a friend, as a girlfriend, of as the love of your life, please go on my cameo page. I still can do a few before Sunday. And I will be seeing you actually Saturday, 2 days from now. I'm going to take you again to Italy because with another recipe, because Saturday I will be making for you saltimbocca alla romana, which we're going to Rome, we're going to Roma for this traditional recipe. Beside the pasta alla carbonara, another famous dish from Rome is, of course, the saltimbocca alla romana. And I'm going to teach you how to make it. So I'm going to see you Saturday in the kitchen and then Sunday on my Patreon page. Please like my page because tomorrow you're going to be see me also tomorrow. You're going to see me as guest of Lina Prima for Buongiorno Louisiana, the radio show. I will be singing also there an Elvis Presley song. And wearing a spectacular gown of Randolph Duke, so you don't want to miss that. And then what else? Tune in now for Rita Monte, 25 anni di radio, congratulazioni again. And what else? What did I forget? Oh, and tomorrow morning, I think I have also another podcast at 10 in the morning, Vegas time. Is a podcast live, me in Las Vegas, and Darcy is in Chicago. So this is happening tomorrow morning. And guys, I'm going to see you there. And so tomorrow there, and then Saturday in the kitchen for saltimbocca alla romana, and then Sunday for Valentine's Day. Guy, sign language, very important sign. We have love. We are connected for life here on the circle of love, and I send you my love. And guys, never forget that I love you. Ci vediamo domani. Ciao. See you tomorrow. Danke schön. Dear old Dankeschön, thank you for seeing me again. Though I'm here in my solitude, I know you are there, and in my heart I smile again. And so I sing here in my solitude, waiting see you, same time, same place, and I can't wait to say again, Dankeschön, Dankeschön, Dankeschön.